Hello and praise the Lord. My name is Pastor Tony McGee, and I'm so blessed to serve as a senior pastor of Zion Hope Church, located on the east side of Indianapolis. On behalf of myself, Lady Kim, and the entire Zion Hope Church family, I want to thank you for visiting with us today. At Zion Hope, our mission is to advance the kingdom of God through effective evangelism, discipleship, and service. Our vision is to be a church that loves, a church that grows, and a church that serves. If you'd like to learn more about our ministry and how we impact our community, you can check us out on our website, www.zionhopechurch.org. You can also connect with us through our Zion Hope Church Facebook page, or you can connect with us on the Zion Hope Church YouTube channel. If you do not currently have a church home, why don't you give prayerful consideration to being part of the Zion Hope family? I would love to be able to serve as your pastor. My prayer is that you will continue to come again and visit us soon. Hope is here. Hope is now. And there is hope for your future. I hope to see you at the Hope, Zion Hope. May God bless you. May God keep you. And may heaven smile upon you. Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I want to thank you for tuning in and welcome you to Zion Hope Church and our online worship service. My name is Tony McGee, and I have the privilege of serving as the pastor of Zion Hope Church for the last 11 years, one of the greatest churches on this side of heaven. We are so thankful to God that you've joined us for our online worship experience today. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is First Sunday. And on First Sunday, we observe the Lord's Supper. On First Sundays, we observe the Lord's Supper. We remember the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. This is significant for us as believers because Jesus told us to have communion in remembrance of Him and the sacrifice that He made on Calvary's mountain when He laid down His life for the remission of our sins. So today, we're going to have communion and we're going to have it together. So go ahead, I want you to go and get your crackers. I want you to get your juice. Get your crackers and get your juice ready. And what we're going to do is we're going to play some soft music while you go and get the sacraments together. So go and get your juice and go and get your crackers. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, beginning with verse 23, the Apostle Paul writes these words, "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, 'This is My body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of Me.' In the same way, after supper, He took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in My blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of Me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes. Therefore, whoever eats of the bread or drinks of the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. A man ought to examine himself before he eats the bread and before he drinks of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on himself." Lord, we thank You for Your goodness, Your grace, Your love, and Your tender mercy. Thank You, Lord, for watching over us and keeping us. And thank You for allowing us to observe this, the Lord's Supper. Lord, we pray if there's anything unpleasing in Your sight, We pray that it be removed right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we repent of our sins. We confess our sins, knowing you're faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Lord, we ask that you will bless the bread, which represents the beaten, battered, and broken body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we pray that you will bless the cup, which represents the blood that was shed on Calvary's mountain. It's in Jesus' name we pray and give thanks. Amen. Let us partake of what represents the body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And let us partake of the cup, which represents the blood that was shed on Calvary's mountain. Each of you ought to feel so much better today because we had the opportunity to come together and sup with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We remembered his death, his burial, and his resurrection. Now that we've had a chance to sup with him, let us get our praise and our worship on as our praise team gets ready to bless us in an awesome and amazing way. So wherever you are, put your hands together, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. The psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. So come on, y'all, put your hands together as our praise team comes, as we worship and praise the Lord together.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, anybody. Well, praise the Lord, somebody. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. The psalmist said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Are y'all going to help us sing today? Are y'all going to help the praise team sing today? Amen. Amen. We're in for a good time to the Lord today. Amen. So we want you to sit back and just enjoy yourself. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer. Eternal Father, our God, once again, Master, you have done what you do best. You've shown up and you've shown out. You've blessed us, you've kept us, and you've allowed us another opportunity to come to this thy house one more time to praise your holy, righteous, and divine name. Now, Master, give us the visitation of your Holy Spirit as we uplift your name in spirit and in truth. Bless this praise team, bless the musicians, Father God, as we uplift your name, Father God, for you're worthy of all of our praise today, Father God. Bless each and every one is here today, Father God. Bless those, Father God, who are watching virtually, Father God. Just praise them, Father God, and touch them in a way that only you can. Father God, we love you. We love you more than anything. We ask you, God, to bless the spoken word today, Father God, as it comes from our senior pastor, Pastor Tony McGee, Father God. Most of all, Father God, we want to say thank you, and we want to thank you, Father God, for Jesus and our salvation. It's in Jesus' name we pray and give all thanks. And all God's children said amen,
amen,
amen, and amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody on Facebook.
Praise the Lord.
I just wanted to give God a praise and a worship on this morning.
Yes, Jesus.
We're going to do something a little bit different. We got Sister Deanna, we got Sister Deborah, and Sister Tanya. And we want you to just sit back and relax and kind of vibe with us a little bit.
Yes.
This first song we're going to do is talking about how God will not put more on you than you can handle.
Thank you, Jesus.
And that you can bear. So whatever the situation is, whatever the circumstances are, we just want to let you know that if you got it, then that means God has equipped you.
Yes.
He will sustain you, and he will provide for you.
Amen.
So you can handle it, you can get through it. Yes. And we want you to keep that in mind. We want you to get with us on this. Amen.
Amen.
If in your life,
if in your life you are going through.
song says just call.
Just call on Jesus, he will see you through. For he knows, Jesus, he knows.
Come on, say it again.
If in your life you are going through and you don't know really what to do, just call on Jesus, he will see you through.
For he knows.
For he knows, Jesus, he knows.
He knows just how much. Jesus, he knows.
Jesus, he knows how much we can bear.
I have a second verse for you. It says, if there's a trial,
if there's a trial, then it's come your way. And you are looking for a brighter day.
Just call.
Just call on Jesus, he will make a way. For he knows, Jesus, he knows.
Say it again.
If there's a trial,
how much
we can bear.
Come on, stay right there and say how much.
How much?
All right.
We can bear.
He knows everything about you, and he knows just how.
How much?
Yeah.
We can bear.
Come on, let's take it up. Come on, let's take it up again.
All right.
He knows how.
How much. Yeah.
Yeah.
We can bear.
Thank you.
Come on,
thank you.
How much.
Yeah.
We can bear.
Yeah.
Come on, how much.
How much.
Woo.
Yeah.
Come on, say it again. How much.
How much.
We can bear. Put your hands together.
Yes.
Put your hands together.
Thank
you know that God knows how much you can handle.
Yes.
He knows how much you can bear.
Yes.
He will be there to help you.
Thank
he will be there to sustain you.
Thank
he will be there to keep you.
Thank
he will be there to provide for you and to protect you. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Praise the Lord, church.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
How many of you know that whatever you're going through, if you trust in the Lord and have faith, he will see you through. I know he will, because he said he will. I know it for a fact, because he's done it for me.
Amen.
Just hold on to the Lord, and he will handle everything for you. Yes, he will.
Yes.
Come on, here we go. Who opened doors? Let's say that again. Who opened doors?
Who opened doors that eyes cannot see?
How many know that Jesus will?
Jesus will. Jesus will.
I have a second verse for you. Who will make all? Come on, when I'm in. Say that again. The song says, when I'm in trouble,
when I'm in trouble,
he will give.
He gives me a song.
And in the night season,
in the night season,
and all the day,
and all the day long.
Yeah. Who makes me? Come on, put your hands together and say, oh yeah.
Jesus will.
Come on, say it again.
Jesus.
How many of you know that Jesus will? Don't play with me. Now, how many of you know that Jesus will? He'll bring you through every trial, every tribulation, every opposition. Jesus will. He fights your battles for you. Jesus will. All you got to do is call upon the name of Jesus, and he will.
That's Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Come on, y'all. Give me 30 seconds more. 30 seconds more.
Jesus will.
Jesus will.
Come on, Jesus will.
Jesus will.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus Woo! Will. Amen. He will fight all of our battles. Amen. Because he knows when we he knows how much we stand in the need of. He knows what he can do for us. Amen. And he will. Amen. Amen. We're still in for a good time today. We want you to know too. Today is First Sunday, and we will be doing communion. So get your crackers and get your juice ready. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. On behalf of our senior pastor, Tony McGee, Lady Kim, and the entire Zion Hope Church family, we want you to know that we're on a mission here at the Hope. And the mission is to advance the kingdom of God through effective evangelism, discipleship, and service. And our vision here at the Hope is to love, to grow, and to serve. Jesus said he came to serve, not to be served. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And how many here believe in the power of prayer?
Yes.
How many of you truly believe in the power of prayer?
Yes.
We're going to have Minister George Macon come and lead us to the throne of grace and mercy. After the prayer, the next voice you will hear will be our senior pastor, Pastor Tony McGee. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Minister Macon.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's praise good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen?
Yes, amen.
Let us go to God in prayer, because we have no other God to go to beside God that created the earth. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Amen. Praise Heavenly Father. Lord, it's once again, we come before you, humble as we know how, just thanking you for being God and being God all by yourself. God that created the universe and everything therein. God that breathed into the dust of the ground and we became a living soul. Lord, we thank you for one more day. Lord, because we could be dead and in our graves, but you allowed our golden hours to roll on a little while longer, and we just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
But most of all, we thank you for your darling son, Jesus, who you sent and came and died on the cross in our stead. We thank you for eternal life, Lord. We thank you for saving our sin-sick soul, Lord. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to be in this worship experience today, Lord. We want to give you all the praise and all the glory, knowing that you're worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, thou art God, and worthy to be praised. We just want to thank you for all that you've done and all that you're doing and all that you may continue to do. Lord, we ask that you continue to bless our Zion Hope family, for we need you, and we declare we can't make this journey without you. Lord, we ask that we be a church that's sitting on a hill that cannot be hid, Lord. We pray that we be a light in a dark world. Lord, even in this pandemic, Lord, we're going to give you all the glory and all the praise, Lord. Continue to be with our pastor. Prop him up on every leaning side. We ask that you give him preaching power, give him teaching power, Lord. Give him loving power, Lord. We pray that he just stay in your will.
Yes, Jesus.
Continue to be with Lady Kim. Comfort her and strengthen her, Lord, as she goes along beside her husband. Bless the first family, Lord. Lord, we ask that you might forgive us for our sins, though they be many. Lord, we ask that you just blot them out of the book of remembrance and remember them no more. Because you said in your word that if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness, Lord. And then, Lord, we pray for this sin-sick world. Lord, we pray that they might answer your call, because your call is worthy to answer, Lord. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for keeping us, Lord. Some of us feel like throwing in the towel, Lord, but you kept us in spite of us, Lord. We ask that you bless that alcoholic that can't put down the bottle. Bless that drug addict that just can't put down the dope. Bless that one that's going through depression, Lord, and can't tell nobody, Lord. But we know that they can tell you, Lord, because you are a prayer-hearing God and a prayer-answering God, Lord. We know that you will meet us at our point of need, Lord. So we call upon you today, Lord, just to continue to be with us, continue to lead us, continue to guide us, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for one more sunny day. It's another day's journey. Somebody said, I'm glad about it. Lord, we thank you for saving us. We thank you for keeping us, Lord. We thank you for making the sacrifice. Lord, we thank you, and we be so careful to give you all the praise and all the glory, knowing that you're worthy, knowing that you're worthy to be praised. It's in the precious and matchless name of Jesus we do pray. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Minister Macon, for leading us in that powerful prayer. And thank you to our praise team that led us in such an awesome way, helping us to praise and worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Well, there's a word from the Lord. There's a word from the Lord found in Micah chapter 7, verses 2 and 3. Micah chapter 7, verses 2 and 3, and verses 7 and 8. Micah chapter 7. Verses 2 and 3, and verses 7 and 8. And it reads, the godly people have all disappeared. Not one honest person is left on earth. They are all murderers, setting traps even for their own brothers. Both their hands are equally skilled at doing evil. Officials and judges alike demand bribes. The people with influence get what they want, and together they scheme to twist justice. Verses 7 and 8. As for me, I look to the Lord for help. I wait confidently for God to save me, and my God will certainly hear me. Verse 8. Do not gloat over me, my enemies. Though I fall, I will rise again. Though I sit in darkness, the Lord will be my light. Today, I want to preach and teach from the subject, I'm making a comeback. I'm making a comeback. The times that we're living in right now, they're discouraging and they're disheartening. This pandemic that we're dealing with has caused us to panic and our nation to be paralyzed. COVID has seemed to cripple our country. Social injustice and inequality has stretched the moral fabric of our lives. We just saw a presidential debate that was a disastrous debacle. It seems like we've hit an all-time low. But today I want you to know that God wants you to make a comeback. God wants you to come back from your painful predicament. God wants you to come back from that catastrophic condition. And God wants you to come back from that hurt that has hindered you. God designed you to make a comeback. And God wants you to be an overcomer, not for you to be overcome. Today, I want you to know, my friends, that you can make a comeback. If you believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you are filled with the Holy Spirit, then yes, you can make a comeback. Every time the enemy tries to get you down, every time the enemy tries to defeat you or discourage you, I want you to know you can get right back up. Your difficulty doesn't have to defeat you. It may have derailed you temporarily. However, when you believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, it's just a matter of time before you can get your life back on track. So today, I want you to make a decision to make a comeback. Today, rise to the occasion. Rise and make the great comeback, and do it starting today. I wonder if there's anybody that's tuned in today that will say and agree with me that I'm making a comeback. If you agree with me that you're going to make a comeback, then right now I want you to type in your comment section, I'm making a comeback. Here in the text, the prophet Micah, who has served faithfully in ministry as a prophet for over 50 years, and y'all, that's a long time to be a prophet for 50 years. Micah the prophet says in verse 7 and 8, as for me, I look to the Lord for help. I wait confidently for God to save me, and my God will certainly hear me. Do not gloat over me, my enemies, for though I fall, I will rise. Though I sit in darkness, the Lord will be my light. Times were dark during Micah's ministry. They were very dark. In verse 2, Micah says that all the godly people had disappeared. He says that there's no honest person that is left on earth. The people have become murderers, and they have been setting traps for their own brothers and fighting within their families. Then he comes in verse 3 and says that both of their hands, the evil, they are skilled in doing evil. Officials and judges, they're being appointed by wicked leaders and being bribed. The people with great influence, they got what they wanted, and they got together with the wicked leaders and the appointed officials and the judges, and they schemed together to twist justice. That's what was happening, y'all, back in Michael's day. But it's also the same thing that we see happening to us today. So what was happening during Micah's day is happening today. We have murderers who are walking the streets, who are not even being charged with murder, because appointed elected officials have corrupted our system. We have leaders who chose not to speak up against white supremacy, and they continue to work to oppress the least, the lost, the left behind, and the left out. People with money, people with power, people with influence have schemed, and they're even scheming right now, trying to twist justice and even cast doubt upon the upcoming election. Times were dark during Micah's time, and times are dark for us right now. Micah witnessed the people turning their backs against God and turning their backs against each other, just as we see today. However, Micah, he didn't complain about the trouble. He didn't get into an argument or get into debates. Micah didn't go on a Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram rant. He didn't call up everybody who worshiped together in the temple and cry and complain and say, woe is me, woe is me. No, instead, Micah said in verse 8, don't gloat over me, my enemies, for though I fall, I will rise again. Micah said, even though things are bad, I'm making a comeback and I am going to rise. In the midst of the darkness, Micah said, God will be my light. He didn't accept defeat in his difficulty. He says, I'm going to rise. Y'all, I understand that things are difficult right now. We can't come together and worship at the church right now. Things are difficult. We can't come together and worship. I understand that we have a COVID crisis. I understand that we have racial tension, and I understand that your health may be failing you. I understand that you may have lost somebody that's been close to you. I understand, y'all, that money is funny and change is strange, but today I need for you to believe that you can make a comeback. Y'all, you have to say that my problem is not going to stop me from producing, that my hurt is not going to hinder me and my ability to achieve. Why? Because God is for me, and God being for me is more than the world being against me. Today, I'm deciding that I'm going to make a comeback. Y'all, when you have a comeback attitude, you can say that sickness is not going to stop me. When you have a comeback attitude, you can say that my family is not going to be destroyed. When you have a comeback attitude, you can say, my finances are going to be fixed. And my mind is going to be like that of Jesus Christ. And I'm making a comeback because I have an I can do attitude. And I know that I can do all things through Jesus Christ who gives me my strength. And I'm making a comeback starting today. God has not brought you this far to leave you. In verse 7. Micah says, as for me, I look to the Lord for help. I wait confidently for God to save me, and my God will certainly hear me. The prophet is saying, God, he sees my pain. God, he sees the immorality of the people around me. And God sees the current predicament that I'm in. Yet, as bad as it is, I'm confident that God will save me and God will hear me when I call on him. And I need for someone who is tuned in right now to know that God hears you and that God is able to save you. From the pit of your pain, God hears you. From your tunnel of trouble, God hears you. From the cave of corruption and corona, God hears you. But not only does God hear you, but God will, watch this, God will raise you out of the darkness and bring you into the light. God will raise you out of your darkness and usher you into the life. God will lift you. God will raise you. God will elevate you. And you can rise above the darkness. You can rise above discouragement. You can rise above depression. You can rise above your opposition. If you put your faith and your trust in God, you can rise. Do you remember David? David, who was a man after God's own heart, David says in Psalms 40 and 2, David says, God lifted me out of a pit and he set my feet upon a rock. Did you hear that? David said that God lifted me out of the pit and he set my feet on a rock. And I don't know what pit you're in right now. You may feel like you're in a pit and you can never give out. You feel like you're trapped in this pit. Well, the good news is this. You're not trapped and you don't have to stay in the pit. Because when you believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, he's your rock. And God will bring you out. And not only will he bring you out, but God will set you up on the rock so that you can make a comeback. Y'all, you can come back from that broken relationship. You can come back from losing your job. You can come back from making a bad financial decision. You can come back if your business failed. You can come back if you've messed up at school. You can come back even if you've been messing up at home. Because God, he will lift you and he will set your feet on the rock, Jesus Christ, so that you can stand. Y'all, my brothers and sisters, today is the day for you to take a stand. Today is the day for you to commit yourself to making a comeback. Today, you can defeat that addiction. I want you to know you can overcome that negative attitude and mentality. You can bounce back from your mistakes. You can get up and you can make a comeback today. The Apostle Paul says in Romans 8 and 11, the Apostle Paul says in Romans 8 and 11, he says, the same spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead lives inside of you. Listen to what the Apostle Paul said. He said, the same spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, he said, it lives inside of you. Well, what does that mean, Pastor T? That means that the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead is the same spirit that can raise you from any dead situation or circumstance you face in your life. The same spirit that overcame the enemy when the enemy tried to defeat Jesus and make him die, he was raised from the dead, that same spirit will help you to overcome the enemy yourself. And that same spirit, it lives inside of you. So this pandemic, it can't stop you because the Holy Spirit's in you. Political unrest, it can't stop you. The forces of darkness and evil cannot stop you. Why? Because the same Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead will help you to rise up and to be able to make a comeback. Stop talking about what you can't do and start talking about what you can do. Stop looking at the negative and focus on the positive. Stop saying, and it's too hard for me and it's too difficult, because nothing, and I mean nothing, is too hard or too difficult for our God when you stand on Jesus. It's time to make a comeback. My brother, he lives in Florida, and I remember having a conversation with my brother, and my brother, he told me about a time when a hurricane came through a city. And when the hurricane came through the city, all the trees, the big trees and the small trees, they couldn't withstand the strong winds of the hurricane. Trees, they were blown down. Trees, they were broken, and trees, they were uprooted. However, there was one tree that did not blow down. There was one tree that didn't blow down. And this tree was the palm tree. And what's interesting about the palm tree is this. God designed the palm tree to withstand winds and storms, even hurricanes. And all the other trees bent and broke, but the palm tree, it didn't break. The palm tree is made so that it can be able to bend over for hours and hours, almost touching the ground. But after the wind calms down and after the storm passes away, it comes right back up. Why? Can the palm tree make a comeback? Because God made it that way. And if God made it possible for a palm tree to make a comeback, how much more does God, who loves you and created you, want you to make a comeback? Yes, you may have been bent over during your storms. Yes, you may have been blown to and fro by the winds of life. But the Holy Spirit is alive and active inside of you. And God has put everything that you need inside of you so that you can be able to make a comeback. You may have been pushed down, y'all. But today, like the palm tree, you're going to bounce back. A storm may have wreaked havoc on your home. There's a hurricane that's brewing that wreaked havoc on you at the job. The storm has wreaked havoc in all of your relationships, and it may have even wreaked havoc in your ministry. But today, you can still make a comeback. Look at Psalms 92 and 12. Psalms 92 and 12 says, "The righteous will flourish like a palm tree." The righteous, those who have a right relationship with God through his son, Jesus Christ, the righteous will flourish. The righteous will not only survive, but the righteous will thrive. The righteous will grow, and the righteous will succeed just like a palm tree. God knew that the storms of life could destroy our destiny, but he wants you to know that you can survive and you can thrive in spite of the storm. Your devastation, it doesn't have to derail you. Your condition, it doesn't have to cripple you. And your situation, it doesn't have to stop you. Because greater is he who is inside of you, the Holy Spirit, than he who is in the world. Because you have the gift of the Holy Spirit inside of you, you can make a comeback. You're more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ. Now, I know some of you are saying right now, but Pastor T, I've made way too many mistakes. Or some are saying, I'm too old and it's too late for me. Well, I want you to look at what Solomon, who was known as the wisest man who ever lived besides Jesus, listen to what Solomon says in Proverbs 24 and 16. A good person falls seven times, but they will rise again. A good person falls seven times, but they will rise again. I understand that you messed up. I understand that you may have fallen down. I understand that you had some missteps and you've had some mistakes in life, but it's time for you to get up and make a comeback. Yes, you may fall down over and over again, But Solomon says that you can fall down and keep on falling, but you can get back up and make a comeback. No more woe is me. It's time for you to get up and get back in the game. It's time for you to get up and get your fire back. Just as Pastor Wiggins told us a few weeks ago, we got to fan the flame of our faith and we got to get our fire back. Today, get your drive back. Get your determination back. Today, get your motivation back, because you are getting ready to make a comeback. God knows you. He knows your mistakes. And he knows that you're not perfect, because none of us are. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. God knows that you were at one point in time tore up from the floor up. God knows the mistakes that you've made. But guess what? God still loves you. And because he loves you, he gives you grace and mercy so that you can be able to make a comeback. So get up today and make your comeback. Today is the day for you to arise and go and get what belongs to you. Be who God created you to be and make your great comeback. You may bend, but with God, you won't break. God is going to work things out for your good, and God is working things out for your favor. But you have to trust and believe in him. Get ready. It's time for you to make a comeback. And it starts with you today. I want to extend an invitation for you today, because if you're going to make a comeback, it starts with you acknowledging Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Right now, accept Jesus into your life. Pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I repent of my sins, and I'm asking you to come into my heart. I accept you, Jesus, as my Lord and Savior of my life. I believe that you, Jesus, that you are the Son of God and that you died on the cross for my sins. I want to make a comeback, Jesus. I want to make a comeback today. And so I'm putting my life in your hands. Friends, if you prayed that prayer, then guess what? You're saved and you're on your way to making a comeback. The Holy Spirit is alive and active inside of you, and you're getting ready to experience a brand new life with Jesus Christ. Here at Zion Hope, we want to make sure that we come alongside you in this new journey. So if you would, please call us at 317-547-4387. 317-547-4387. Call us and one of our deacons or our ministry team leaders will come alongside you so that you don't have to make this journey by yourself. We want you to be able to overcome, and we want to be here for you along the way. My prayer is that today you were blessed by this message, and I pray that you are now ready to make a comeback in your life. Before you go, Lady Kim and I would like to thank each and every one of you who made our anniversary celebration so very, very special. Thank you to the Shepherd's Care Ministry and all the volunteers. Thank you for every card, every note, every gift, every expression of love, because each of those things deeply touched us. Thank you, Zion Hope, for being such a blessing to me and to my family. We love you so very, very much. Now, if you would like to contribute to our church financially and support our ministry so that we can continue to be able to serve the people in our community, please send your checks to Zion Hope Church, 5950 East 46th Street, Indianapolis, Indiana, 46226. Or you can download the Giblify app. Select Zion Hope Baptist Church as your church. There's a photo of me that's there. Follow the prompts and you can give securely on Giblify. Or you can visit our website, zionhopechurch.org, and you can give through Giblify or PayPal. Thank you so very much for your gifts. Thank you for your support, and thank you for loving us, Zion Hope. Because of you, we're making a tremendous difference in the kingdom and blessing so many families in our community. I want you to always remember this, that there is hope for today, and there's hope for the future. And today, you can make a comeback. May God bless you. May God keep you. May heaven smile upon you. Have a wonderful and a blessed week. I love you much. Pastor T.